On May 7, 1998, over 50,000 young fans shut down central Tokyo and an extraordinary outpouring of grief at the funeral of the biggest rock star in the history of Japan. The crowd stretched almost a mile along the streets under a blazing sun. The flood of people was so great that the streets were closed off. TV networks went live as ambulances carted away dozens of fans that had screamed themselves sick in a bacchanalian frenzy of grief. The suicide of Japanese rock star Hideto Matsumoto triggered a series of copycat deaths among teenage girls amid an outpouring of grief affecting tens of thousands of young people. Within days of the rocker's death, three girls killed themselves in copycat suicides. The first victim, age 15, was found hanging in her bedroom, described as virtually a shrine to Hide. She died in hospital May 7th. That same day, a 14-year-old killed herself in Hiroshima, and a 17-year-old died in a hotel room in Osaka. Two other girls tried unsuccessfully to take their own lives. The anguish over Hide comes in the wake of growing official concern over suicides and violent crimes by Japanese schoolchildren. Latest statistics show that nearly one death in seven involving youngsters between the ages of 15 and 19 is by suicide. The number rises to about one in four for those between 20 and 24. A young boy was among those on the street the day Matsumoto was laid to rest. I survived my toughest times because of Hide, the 16-year-old schoolboy said. He gave me courage. Another 15-year-old was outside Matsumoto's parents' house, waiting for his ashes to arrive. Clutching a bouquet of white lilies, she said, "This is a very important day for me, a day for me to thank him for helping me continue my life." Hide was overweight as a child and often teased by classmates. He sought escape from his daily life and found it in the American rock band Kiss. Hide was fascinated by the appearance and aggressive music style of the band. By the age of 14, he had saved enough money to buy his first electric guitar. He carried it around with him wherever he went and played it constantly. In his late teens, Hide formed a band called Saber Tiger. Saber Tiger quickly became very popular among Japanese youth. They had a westernized glam look and hard rock sound that was simply unknown in Japan at the time. Soon, word of the band, and Hide in particular, found its way to the ears of a young Japanese musician named Yoshiki. Soon after, Hide received a call from Yoshiki, inviting him to join the band, simply called X. As X came on the scene, Japanese music was mired in corporate control, by-the-numbers, highly derivative pop music. The entire music scene in Japan had become stale and was ripe for change. The change would come through the music and style of unsigned indie band X.
Yeah.
After exploding onto the indie scene in 1985, the members of X jarred club owners by sporting everything from sky-high blonde hair to heavy makeup and glam rags. They broke equipment and threw their instruments, provoking audiences. Bars and hotels banned them. Record labels shunned them. Other bands despised them. X was now taboo. X released their major label debut in 1989's Blue Blood. The release pushed more established acts out of the way. The momentum of X was unstoppable. In 1991, X became the first rock band to perform at the Red and White Music Festival, a national event broadcast on New Year's Eve in Japan. The following year, X became the first Japanese group to sell out the 55,000-seat Tokyo Dome, not just once, but three consecutive days. At the end of the show, when the band played their self-titled hit X, the entire arena linked arms and leapt into the air, landing with a crash so colossal that local residents thought an earthquake had struck. By the mid-1990s, X was at the top of the Japanese music industry. Yoshiki's drumming was so extreme that he broke his wrists and damaged his spine. But for each concert that was stopped, a new one was held. Even if 80% of a show had been completed, X performed a makeup show for their fans. One member thought the dedication was too much. In May 1997, lead singer Toshi officially left X, and the band dissolved. Around 1993, Hide began to branch out from his role in X and release his own solo music whenever he wasn't occupied with duties as a member of X. Through his solo work, Hide really proved that he was not restricted by the typical XJapan sound. In fact, he would become an entirely different artist when on his own. Once Hide put himself in a situation where he had complete creative control and freedom, you really could see what an extremely talented artist he really was. Being the guitarist of a heavy metal band would lead you to think that his music would be pretty predictable, but not so. The music of Hide with Spread Beaver is what rock should be, a lot of fun. It's a form of punk rock that has Hide's genius for mixing musical genres. On May 2, 1998, Hide was found unconscious in his apartment, suspended from a doorknob by a towel around his neck. Hide died May 2, 1998, around 8:30. He reached home at 6:30 and was very drunk. An hour later, he was found by his girlfriend. He had tried to hang himself at the door. Hide died on the way to the hospital. It was declared a suicide by police and media, but friends and fans couldn't believe this. There seemed no reason. Hide had a lot of plans and wasn't depressed. Some say it was an accident because he was so drunk, or he wanted to scare his girlfriend. When he was drunk, he often did things he wouldn't do otherwise and often was scared afterwards. Some speculate that the lyrics to the song Pink Spyder by Hide, which was set to be released the day after his death, is a suicide note of sorts. However, shortly after Hide's death, they started to release the remaining singles and videos. Hide was already incredibly popular, and if anything, his death made him even more popular.